the ice sheets are changing faster than we thought they could. My job is to understand how the ice sheets work, because I want to make it so we can understand better how they're going to change in the future. Right now, we've been studying this big piece of floating ice called the Ross Ice Shelf. It's almost as big as Texas. And so a piece of ice that big is really holding back a lot of the glaciers that are trying to flow into the ocean. But it's the least known piece of ocean floor on our planet. The real question to understanding how the ice sheets work is you have to look through them and underneath them. Well, that's our job. We do the MRI and CAT scans of the ice.
My name is Nick Frierson. I'm lead engineer on the IcePod program. It's quite a departure for us to be able to put scientific equipment in these little pods here on the plane. And we can actually do it by attaching the pod to an arm and then to this door, which you kind of attach into the doorway of the plane, so we don't have to drill any holes in the plane. And the pod is then underneath the plane, and the sensors, they actually look out underneath this and down into the ice. And so when you're looking down through the ice, you're actually looking back in history. And you can be looking back hundreds of thousands of years in time.
So we've spent the last 3 years with the ice pod flying over this floating piece of ice to try and discover what's underneath, what's hidden there, and how it's going to influence the changing ice in the future. So that's what IcePod let us do. It meant that we could take the suite of instruments, you know, our airborne CAT scan MRI, and hang it off of any C-130. So inside the pod is a radar that lets you measure how thick the ice is, a radar that lets you look at the beautiful layering in the ice, a laser to shoot at the surface, so you know where the surface is, a camera so you can look to see what it looks like, an infrared camera so you know what temperature it is, and then we measure gravity and magnetics so we know whether or not there's a volcano under there or whether there's lots of mud. What we've found is that the water is much deeper in places than we thought. We've found a boundary between East and West Antarctica, and we've seen how the ice shelf melts when warm water gets under it. People around the globe are worried about rising sea level. And we all have to look at how to have a more sustainable future on our planet.